Good morning, folks. Hillbilly here with some of the crew. Satellite and Cass right behind me. 3M down the road there. We are up here at Dolly Sods at Bear Rocks. Check out that sunrise right there. That's beautiful. Anyway, we are here at Bear Rocks. We're here for the weekend. We've got a very unique, kind of special hike we're doing this weekend. We're going to be the first to attempt, at least that I know of, to walk from Bear Rocks here in Dolly Sods, through the Sods, through Roaring Plains, down Smith Mountain, and to Seneca Rocks. So we're trying to hike from Bear Rocks to Seneca Rocks. There's no official route from one to the other. We'll be using multiple trails and roads, pipelines to get there. But it should be pretty interesting. It should be a cool route. Been looking forward to this one for a few years. Been kind of researching, planning, figuring out how to make it happen. And here we are. So it's chilly up here. It's in the 40s, but beautiful up here at Bear Rocks. Extremely crowded, but we're not going to be hanging around here for long. We're just getting our stuff together. I'm going to walk down here to meet Jay. He camped up here last night. We all stayed at the Homestead Inn down in Petersburg. But yeah, I'm going to get down here, grab Jay, walk up to Bear Rocks, and officially start this thing. So appreciate you tuning in and tagging along, and let's go do it. All right, we are up here at Bear Rocks. Beautiful sunrise, some cloud inversion, fog down in the valleys. Man, what a hell of a beautiful spot. Great spot to start this adventure. Got the crew. You guys ready for this? We're gonna make history.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Blazing new ground.
What time is it?
7:51.
7:51. A little bit later than what I was hoping to start, but who cares? We're here. We are officially getting on the Bear Rocks Trail. This is the first trail of the many trails we'll be on. It's one of my favorite trails up here.
I just drank the one Reds, one can of Reds, and I made myself lay down, and it was a good decision, I think.
Mine was a bad decision. I had been drinking since we got here. And I woke up really regretting that. I feel good now.
It's amazing what fresh air and a beautiful sunrise will do for you.
Yeah, I've been staying long in the truck, just staring at the sky, and I got a couple really good shots of the moon up here and a chemtrail down like this.
I saw the ones you sent. Yeah.
I wasn't, but the government does control the weather.
Definitely some leftover frost down here over this bog. Got down to the 30s last night up here. It's second day of October. And getting ready to cross Red Creek, or the right fork of Red Creek. Take your time. It's a beautiful place. I've always wanted to camp at this spot. Us. Raven Ridge Trail, here we go.
Enjoy your day.
Thank you guys too.
It was
Look at the fucking crackers.
I got crackers.
And those too.
That cracker got some crackers.
I got potted meat to dip them in too if I get all wily.
Oh, I can't do potted meat, man.
Sometimes I fucks with it.
No, my cousin Gary used to eat that shit like just constantly right out of the can.
Yep.
Spin
it. Yep.
Can't do it, bud.
Back when I was eating it that way, I usually just ate it with my finger.
Right. Saint sub rolls for dinner.
So good.
Man, y'all living it up.
Down in the Dobbin grade. It's one of my favorite areas of the sod. It's so wide open and beautiful through here. Everything's just very, very open. It feels huge and wild. But yeah, we're actually still on Raven Ridge Trail, but we are just about to the bottom of it down where it meets Dobbin grade.
Suggest that way.
Let's have a look. Oh wow, that's a good one, bud.
Shit. Damn, that's how mine looked earlier. Well, not as bad, but
nope.
I'm not gonna do what you did.
Well, welcome to the Dobbin Boy Society.
Pretty good, are you? I've been better.
Dude, that was shit. Like a fucking vacuum just
I just heard, oh, my shoe!
I went down towards my fucking knee.
It's funny, I was just telling 3M that I've gotten up over my ankle through here somewhere.
I've never been down here, so it's kind of appropriate that you have like an introduction to what the experience is.
It's an initiation, for sure.
Look at all this. Yeah, if you can come up like here, you can probably rinse a lot of that stuff out.
Yeah, there's a creek crossing right over here. Let me get a picture of that shoe.
Why didn't you just let me, like, why did you have to, like, sprint to get to the trail?
I jumped.
I made it back without getting muddy.
Yeah, leaping is majorly frowned upon because it turns your 250-pound pack and frame into 600 pounds.
Let's go wrench your foot off, man. It's literally right over here.
Yep. You can hop in the stream. I turned around, I was like, what the fuck? Cass got a lot shorter.
and then he fell.
Looked like somebody chopped your leg off.
Right in front of a group of people. Like the only other people out here, Cass falls in front of them.
Oh, good shit.
You look good doing it.
You did, you looked excellent.
Alright.
So our short stay on Dobbin grade is over. Hitting the upper Red Creek Trail here now.
It was eventful.
You have the very, very short stay on Dobbin grade. Has certainly left its mark on this hike. We're going to go wash off Cass's shoe. Alright, done with Upper Red Creek. On Blackbird Knob for just a couple of few tenths of a mile up to where the Red Creek Trail meets us. Cruising along, we've done about 5.5 miles in the past 2.5 hours, and we had a pretty significant snack break. Sitting down talking for a while. A couple that walked by. Anyway, we're making good time. Still
great
got
time.
A lot of miles to put down.
Great huh? day to be here. How about that shit?
Alright, so we have left our quick little dash on Blackbird Knob Trail, and we're now on the Red Creek Trail. We will be following this for a little while, a little less than a mile from the forks of Red Creek right now. We may stop there and have a short break. And then keep on going down Red Creek. Eventually today we're going to hit a low and then start climbing back up again out of Red Creek up Fisher Spring. But until then we've got some pretty cruisy trail conditions. Generally downhill, generally smooth.
Weather's amazing. Perfect day out here. But anyway, we're probably about 6 miles in. And still relatively early. What time is it? 3 a.m.?
10:40.
It's not bad. All right, we're here at the Falls Red Creek. I think we're going to take a short break here. Love this spot. Sarah and I came here just a couple of weeks ago. Took a break here. See the branches of Red Creek come together. Very beautiful. All right, so we are still on Red Creek Trail, just past its intersection with Rocky Point Trail. So I am actually on new trail. I've never been from that point down to Fisher Spring along Red Creek Trail, so that's cool. Got a couple new trails on this hike that I haven't been on. But yeah, still going down. It's going to be one of our lowest elevations down here where we cross Red Creek, and then we got to go right back up the mountain again on the other side.
Put that pole in the water.
That's already come good. First it felt good, then it didn't.
Good grief, that's some cold ass water. Nice. Good stuff. I'm going to put my socks and shoes back on now. Regain feeling in my toes.
Standing on this side, we gathered up a little wood. That spot that we were at the falls was the spot.
You were right. Yeah. Looks totally different.
Wow. All right, so we are still on Red Creek Trail, but we've come down just a little ways, and we've actually found the campsite that we all... where we all met. We had our first rendezvous here as a crew. We all met, hung out, and tried some delicious food.
Yes. And we've
yeah, it's pretty cool to be back here. It was snow everywhere when we were here last time. It was cold as hell. Fur on the ground. Yeah, I was out here on the peninsula. Set up right here. It's pretty cool to be back here. Some fuck around gang history. Yeah. All right, been on Fisher Spring Run. Yeah. All right, we're gonna be climbing up away from Red Creek at this point. Gonna be some good climbing. Coming down Fisher Spring, coming up Fisher Spring Trail, I should say. And there's fire still sitting here burning and smoking. We're literally right beside a creek. There's no reason this should still be burning. I'm gonna fill up my water bag and douse the shit out of this thing. Mm-hmm. All right, so we are getting ready to exit the Fisher Spring Run Trail and jump on the Roar Ball. This last little section of Fisher Spring Run Trail is pretty flat. I think it's probably an old road bed or maybe old railroad bed. Climbing up off the Red Creek though was a doozy. That was pretty steep. Anyway, here comes another trail I've never been on. Roarball Plains. Satellite doing her thing. The reason she earned her name in the first place.
Gotta talk to my children.
Satellite.
All right, we're beginning to wonder if we'd have any water between here and camp, or back there in camp, I should say, but We've got a nice little source here, so we'll go ahead and water up. Oh shit. So you're gonna take your pants off?
Yeah.
Nice spot. Cliffs. They're across from us right there. Right there. It's Lion's Head. And down over Red Creek. Roaring Plains and Roarball Plains right here behind us. Man, what a beautiful, beautiful spot. You can see the pines up on top of Lion's Head where everybody camps. Big pine patch. It's Breast Mountain. Beautiful.
Can you see where we started?
All right. So we are at Forest Road, Forest Road 19. We walked from here across here, there, and down, and down. And down, oh wait, back here, up, across there, now we're there. So we got a little over 2 miles left, I think. We're about to leave Dolly Sods proper, and we'll be entering our Roaring Plains after a quick walk down this forest road. All right, it's about 4 o'clock now, I guess. It's not too bad.
Yeah, that's where we're going across the road.
Doing pretty decent.
That's where we just were.
Oh, it feels weird to be back out in the open again. It's the Dolly Sods picnic area right over here.
Deep winter camping here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm gonna have a sit for a moment. There's a privy.
Face dropped or nothing.
I think I need my sunglasses out here. Walking down Forest Road 19. You're hiking for your soul, hiking for your sins.
I'm hitchhiking, just so you guys know.
You're hitchhiking.
You're going to cheat a beast tonight.
You're going to cheat a beast. You know, if we'd have been smart, we'd have staged a car here. Yep. Hiked here, went to fucking cheat a beast. Went to cheat a beast, came back, and they kept hiking.
You motherfuckers, that I fucking said that yesterday.
We could all have
did you tell
beer?
Him I said that?
Yeah, I did.
They mentioned about staging a car here. They did not mention for the purpose of going to cheat a beast.
Well, I mean,
they,
I was thinking cheetahs because I didn't know what
cheetah beast.
I didn't know what a fucking cheetah was.
Would that have been? You better learn, Buster. Cheetah beast is that? Where it's at.
We could have done that. Yeah, what we're saying.
Yeah, because right down here is where it would have been parked.
You see this opportunity we all missed for a draft beer?
You know, yeah, there would have been a cooler full of beer in it, too, waiting
we
for
us. We
have
cooler beers as well.
We wouldn't have had to carry the beer all day.
I just left my fucking whole entire pack in my truck. And
yeah.
The slack pack. We really botched this one, guys.
I'm telling you, when we bring 3 vehicles, it needs to be like we got a support station along the hike.
We need to do this again and try it the other way.
Let's go back. We'll back try up again. There, Bear Rocks. We'll start again tomorrow.
only way to keep on cooler then.
Welcome to the Roaring Plains. Alright. South Prong Trail. We're going to leave the forest road here and head back into the woods. I've never been to Roaring Plains, so I'm stoked on this. I think 3M is the only one of us here who has had the pleasure of hiking here. So I've been excited to check it out. It's supposed to be a little bit more of a rugged version of Dolly Sods, so that'd be pretty cool. Alright, so about 2 miles till camp. Alright, so we have just found the hidden passage trail up here in Roaring Plains, and we have found our campsite. And look at this, man. Right off the jump, we got a nice little stream running. Big grassy area. Chairs, fucking wood. Damn, ladies and gentlemen, this is the payoff I was hoping for. This is nice, very nice. Welcome home, fuckers. Woo. Hell yeah, I can do this. All right, so yeah, we're at camp. It's been a long day. My feet hurt, I'm tired. I'm ready to have a drink. And yeah, I'm gonna start getting set up. All right, folks, so we are finally getting settled in here. 3M's Tarp Palace over there. But man, this is a fantastic camping site right here. It's got a little cairn kind of marking the trail to this campsite right off of the South Prong Trail, right next to where the Hidden Passage Trail comes off of it. Hidden Passage is what we're taking in the morning. But man, like I said, we got a wonderful little stream right here, a little creek, ravine, whatever the fuck you want to call it. Listen to the new Billy Strings album, getting ready to start eating. Got all the tents and everything set up. I got the tarp back out. Had it out a couple weekends ago with 3M in Pennsylvania. Been using a triplex a lot lately with my sweetheart Sarah, but I couldn't justify bringing that monster out and when it's just me. We're doing kind of high miles. But man, today was a big day. Today was a good day. It was a beautiful day. The temperatures, the weather was absolutely perfect. I'd say mid to high 60s tops. Pretty decent breeze most of the day. The trail was very favorable. It wasn't a whole lot of like difficult uphill. Not much, at least. A little bit coming up Fisher Spring run up from Red Creek. And I mean, really that was it, honestly. But yeah, we're here in the Roaring Plains. We're just off South Prong Trail. Very excited to be in the Roaring Plains. It's my first time here. And I'm very excited about this route. This is a very kind of unique route that we're doing. Like I said, as far as I know, I can't find any evidence that anybody's done this route before. So kind of hoping to make this a thing for the casual avid backpacker. Casual avid backpacker, is that a thing? But it's just a little over 30 miles total. It's like 32 miles. Bare Rocks to Seneca Rocks, using mostly established trails and some road walking. But it can be done in a weekend by more serious backpackers. Or it can be done in a 3-day weekend by, you know, kind of your average backpacker. I think it's a really cool route. And I've been excited about it for a while. So very cool to be out here finally getting this done. Again, day one couldn't have been any more beautiful. Great hiking, great weather, obviously great company. Missing OSHA out here on this one. We don't have OSHA on this one. Him and Endo are back home taking care of the garden. But it's good to have the rest of the crew out here anyway. We haven't been together since the North Fork Mountain Trail a couple months ago, which I still need to make the video for. I still haven't made the video for that. Getting a little bit behind here. I did a video for North Fork Mountain. Got to do the video for 3M and I's Tuscarora Trail hike a couple of weekends ago. Anyway, I'm rambling. We're here. It's a great, great spot. We're all settling in, getting ready to get fed, having a couple drinks, listening to some good music. And glad to be here. Perfect end to a perfect day.
At the bar, they're like $20 a glass. Maybe tell me what you
I've been waiting for this
so long. Making love until the sun comes up. Baby, I just wanna take it nice and slow.
Oh,
my back spasms. Oh, just punch me in the face. Come here. There's an opening. Use me as a closed cell pad.
Come in. What's going on here? Don't be
shy.
I don't
know. There's so many holes in your hole.
Oh, there's Seneca. Hey. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're settling germs. In for the night. This is my closing monologue. Everybody thought they'd, come and join me, which is cool. At 3 a.m., got Satellite and Cass over there. We've had a great day. The weather was beautiful. We did 17 or 18 miles today, right?
18.
18 miles.
Not or.
we got to an amazing campsite here in the Roaring Plains.
The 69 boys are performing.
The 69 boys are playing currently, doing a 90s playlist tonight.
Roaring Plains met the Backstreet Boys.
Yes, it might be the first time the Backstreet Boys have ever been played in Roaring Plains.
Wu-Tang's been here twice. Wu-Tang's already in a house.
Yeah, Wu-Tang was already on War Ball before we got here. But, yeah, beautiful weather today, amazing temperatures, good breeze, plenty of water to drink, terrain was favorable. We covered a good amount of miles and a good amount of time today. We've had a great camp here. We found a really, really good campsite, as I've pointed out many times already.
There's coons.
Yeah.
A lot of
coons.
Excuse me?
What? Well, there are.
They're chittering right over there.
You hear them?
We just had a whole incident. With
Ralph
them.
Northam, close your ears.
That's getting edited.
But dip, baby, dip, you know. We're here at, Roaring Plains. And it's a great campsite, great night. Had good food, a few good drinks. And it's getting toward the end of the night now. We've got another about 16-ish miles to do tomorrow.
Roxanne!
Down to Seneca Rocks. And, we're going to get a good night's sleep, get a good rest, and tackle 16 more miles tomorrow. So, we'll see you in the morning.
Good night.
Good night.
Perfect. All right, good morning, folks. Day number two. Just getting camp wrapped up here. I think it's, about 8 o'clock or something?
Yep.
Yeah, finally wrapping up camp here. I got up a little late. I got the fire out. Talking about our plans for the day. A lot of road walking today, I think. This campsite, probably said it a million times last night, but this campsite is amazing. Fantastic spot. But, supposed to be another nice day. Might be a little bit of rain later. We'll see. But we got about 16 miles to do again today. So without further ado, let's get to walking. All right, so I do believe this is the Hidden Passage Trail.
Mm-hmm.
804.
Jonathan Jessup's Hidden Passage. Shout out Jonathan Jessup, honorary fuck around gang member. Supposed to be a pretty tight, not necessarily, I don't think it's really overgrown anymore, but I believe it's supposed to be a little bit of a tight trail. But we'll find out. I've been looking forward to this one for a while. And it's got smacked in the eyeball. Man, early morning beauty. Sun's starting to cast its light over top of this plateau.
Oh, wow.
It's quite beautiful. Great way to start the day.
I'll be damned, we do have a couch, don't we?
Yep.
A couch right there.
I would say we ain't fucking around, but we are.
Nice. Even when we ain't fucking around, we're fucking around.
going back to my childhood, my favorite feeling in the world was in the fall when the air was cold, and the sun was warm, and you could feel both at the same time.
Mountain ash. We are here at the pipeline, not the spot of the pipeline I had planned on. What's on that tree right there? Not the spot of the pipeline I had planned on us crossing. We should have crossed it farther down there. But somewhere along the hidden passage, we, I guess, took a right when we should have took a left. But anyway, it brought us out to the same pipeline, no big deal. There's toilet paper over there. Oh, nice.
57
degrees. Let's see. All right. Anyway, yeah, we're at the pipeline portion. We're done with the hidden passage. Getting ready to exit the roaring plains and start getting into some a little bit of unknown. Leaving trails altogether. We'll be following this pipeline on down. And catching a couple roads, so
how fast this car can move.
It'll get interesting from here.
Might not be.
All right, trail coming down the pipeline is a running stream. My feet are definitely soaked already. That's all right. It's part of the fun. But yeah, no lack of water on the pipeline. All right, so we are down here where we should have actually accessed the pipeline at, this trail right here. But it didn't take us long, just a few minutes to walk down this to get to where we're supposed to be. Right there where that cairn marks the beginning of the Canyon Rim Trail, which continues on around the Roaring Plains. But we are gonna continue on this pipeline, like I said, for a ways, get us down off the plateau and down on the Smith Mountain. Like we're walking toward the edge of the earth up here. Dropping off here. There's a sign here, it says something.
Property boundary, national forest, laying behind this sign.
Alright. Alright, we're venturing. We're still on the pipeline, but we saw a cairn. It came up this little scree slope. And there's like a man-made kind of bowl at the top here. Very strange. But man, what a view. Probably an amazing spot to hunt from. That's the canyon there. Canyon Rim Trail would take you on around that next nose too. Man, very, very beautiful. Alright, so we are coming down to the point where this access road we've been walking down actually leaves the pipeline cut and goes into the woods here. It does still parallel the pipeline, but we are leaving the actual pipeline cut. It's a pretty shot right there. Excuse me. Yeah, this pipeline access road will eventually lead us all the way down to Smith Mountain Road. So coming down this pipeline access road, we got some cattle. They're tagged. Just up here roaming around. Some pretty Angus cows there. Pretty. Yeah, we ain't coming for you. Here's the actual pipeline clearing. Man, look at this, dude. This is beautiful. Good grief, man. This is something else. Tell you, I wasn't expecting much out of a road walk, but geez, this has been incredibly beautiful. All right, so we are now coming off of the pipeline access road and meeting up with Smith Mountain Road, which we are going to follow downhill to the right here, all the way down to Route 33 on Seneca Creek. So, man, it's been a hell of a beautiful road walk. But I think we're going to stop here and grab a quick snack, maybe a little bit of an early lunch. Have a break. It's a beautiful spot. Starting to look a little bit like fall down here. All these walnut leaves beginning to drop. Getting down here to much lower elevations. I think we're just about 2,000 feet lower than we were at the top of the pipeline up there. Side of Smith Mountain Road here. Looks like there's an old cemetery. I'm not going to go in it, but I'll walk up to it here. A couple of smaller field stones that can't really tell what they are. Very interesting.
gotta get that time.
Home of Fred the Croc. I know, I was just looking at the red hue it has to the top. Should be dropping us down pretty fast and hard again now that we're off the nose, around the front nose of the mountain.
Yeah.
It's just going to start dropping us down to Seneca Creek.
We're sitting at 2,500 feet right now.
Strut it, Jay. Strut it. The way that thing in your pocket looks and your silhouette looks like you got a big old chubby bub. You're just shaking it around. I think we're taking our last little roadside break before we get off of Smith Mountain Road, because when we get to the bottom, it's going to be Route 33, which is a pretty busy road. So, we really won't have time to or space to get off and pee or stop and take a break or pick our wedgies or whatever we need to do. But still a beautiful day out. Still cruising along, making good time. All right, so we are just about to hit 33. It's right down there, but we're getting our first glimpse at the finish line over there at Seneca Rocks. We are going to be on top of there, celebrating the completion of what has been a pretty epic route. Very cool. The target is in sight. Let's go get it. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we have made it down to Route 33, right where it joins up with Seneca Creek. I'm gonna walk over to this bridge right here and take a nice look at the beautiful Seneca Creek. Alright, get to near the end of the route here if you're hungry. There's a Subway. Not to mention Yoakum's store. It's a little farther down the hill here. But if you're just so hungry that you can't stand it, there's a Subway on this route. Alright, so here we are. Down at the base of Seneca Rocks. We're actually stopping in over here at Yoakum's real quick. I think we're going to grab a cold drink before 3M and I jump up to the top of Seneca Rocks to end this thing. But wouldn't feel right walking past a good cold drink and not grabbing it. So yeah, here at Yoakum's. Alright, we are back to the Subaru. Glad to see my Subi still here. Alright, 3M and I are going to drop a few things off in the Subaru. We carry only just a couple little things we might need at the top. Rain jacket, beer, camera. And then we're going to boogie up to the top and make this thing official. Alright, got our stuff stashed in the Subi. Met a cool hiker down the bottom named Platypus and just found out that Andrew Skirka is looming around here someplace. Be cool to see him. But yeah, got a light load on and getting ready to run this 1 point whatever miles up to the top there. North fork of the south branch of the Potomac River. All right, so we made it up to the observation deck, but we're gonna take it that last bit further. Walk up here to the actual top and call this one done. Here we are.
35 miles and 31 hours.
End of the line, Bear Rocks to Seneca Rocks, 35 miles. Bear Rocks and Dolly Sods, about as far as you can see that way.
We just came from the bottom.
Hey, it's a good climb to get up here from the bottom, ain't no doubt.
Is this gravel roads? He's like, yep, that's all it is. and then we come here.
All right, so we're gonna have a celebratory beer and then climb back down.
She's like me.
Mission accomplished.
Andrew
Skirka.
He's hanging out over there. What? Yeah, we were just hanging out with the person who's hanging out with him.
Are y'all heading over there? I'm heading to get some food.
Alright,
yeah. He does guiding trips around here.
Dolly Sods this weekend.
Yeah, we met a hiker here named Platypus who's doing some guiding for him. We talked to her for a few.
Ooh, baby. How was food?
That's another way she's asked for a rock, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I was just telling him about that.
Only one rock. Because minimalism.
Alright, guys, it's officially over now.
I had an arrogant bastard up there.
Bear Rocks to Seneca Rocks. I think it was 35, 36 miles what it ended up being. We're back down to the Subaru. Got the whole crew here. What an amazing hike. It's very, very unique, very different. Yeah, I was very familiar with the Dolly Sods, although I did get a couple of trails in there that I hadn't done before. But to finally see the Roaring Plains and have an amazing campsite last night, come down that beautiful pipeline, which I did not expect really much from, but it was absolutely stunning coming down that pipeline and that access road. And then Smith Mountain Road was beautiful. It's just been a really, really cool hike, a very, very cool experience. I'll probably put all the total mileages and stuff right here once I get home. But anyway, man, one hell of an adventure. This is one that's been in the book, waiting in the books for me for about 3 or 4 years. I'm looking to get out here to do this, doing a lot of research and a lot of planning, making sure we weren't trespassing on any private property or, you know, doing anything we shouldn't be setting a good example out here doing. Anyway, this is it. I'm gonna go over here to Yoakum's. I'm gonna get some good food. Take these cool cats back to their vehicles up at Bear Rocks and Dolly Sods and then get my ass home. So I appreciate y'all tagging along again, checking out another adventure. Hope you enjoyed this one. I hope some of you adventurous ones out there try this one yourself, because it's a very, very cool experience. But yeah, thanks again, and we'll see you on the next one.